Attention, ladies and gentlemen. August 22nd, 2023. How are you all doing? I can see Gift, Blank, Ipneng. I can see Jay. I can see Ricardo Gonçalves. I can see Railbane. I can see Donat. I can see Jessica. I hope you all can hear me okay. I hope you all can see me okay. And let's talk about this fascinating topic, capability analysis, about two of the most important capability indexes. Let's talk about Cpk and Ppk, and if possible, pen and paper. If possible, pen and paper. Have pen and paper. By the way, where are you in the Lean Six Sigma journey? Where are you in the Lean Six Sigma journey? Are you a white belt? Are you a yellow belt? Are you a green belt? Are you a black belt? Are you a master black belt? Wonderful. So please, today I'll be spending something between 30 and 60 minutes. Lower spec limit is 30 minutes and the upper spec limit is 60 minutes. Let's see if I can meet these specification limits, okay? Amazing. So we have black belt students, we have green belt, certified green belts, we have a white belt, we have a lot of green belts, yellow belts. Okay, excellent. My main objective with you today is to guarantee that you understand that there is one capability index that is more connected to what client or clients are, let's say, feeling, experiencing, okay? So one capability index is more connected to the client experience, yes? And another capability index is more connected, let's say, to what is important to processes, to analysts. Yes, and these two capability indexes are extremely famous, and I have something to tell you. The main reason for me to come here and open up my camera, my mic, and talk to you about Lean Six Sigma topics is to maximize the chances for you to become a well recognized, a respected green, black, or master black belt. Is that clear? Type clear for me. Marcelo, but I am a white belt. I am a yellow belt. So what you are saying is that you are not talking to me. Well, I'm talking to you, but aiming that at some point you become a respected green, black, or master black belt. White belt, it's pretty much awareness. Oh, I know about the make, I know about variation reduction, waste reduction, wonderful. But white belts, they don't run projects. Yellow belts don't run projects in reality, or relevant projects in reality. In order to be capable of running projects in your organization, or if you are an independent consultant in your client, you must be at least a green belt. Marcelo, what's the difference between green belt and black belt? Black belt, they know more advanced tools, sophisticated, fancy tools, you know, to solve more complex problems. Yeah, at the end of the day, it's about problem solving. And so you become more assertive, and so you become more employable. Yes, and master black belt operates as a kind of expert. Yeah, so a master black belt must have a deep knowledge about these topics, and also to operate as the connector between the business strategy and the continuous improvement program. Yes, wonderful. So the main objective of these conversations is to guarantee that you are an amazing green, black, or master. Yeah, and I am selecting topics that normally are kind of gray. This is a gray topic. There's a lot of confusion, a lot of confusion. So today is the day to kill this confusion. Amen. Amen. Cpk in one single number, we are approaching location, variation, and customer specifications. With just one number that varies from minus infinite to plus infinite, we can have minus 10, Cpk equals to minus 10, yes. Can we have Cpk equal to minus 100? Yes. Can we have Cpk equal to 10? Yes. To 1,000? Yes. When Cpk is greater than 1.33, we are inclined to a happiness region, you know? We are inclined to see satisfied customers, yes? But what is Cpk? What is Cpk? Who knows when control charts were created? Who knows? Who knows? When control charts were created. So it was created on 1920s. 1920s. Yeah? 1920s. So pretty much 100 years ago. And let me generate some random data here using Minitab. Yeah, and I'm gonna run here a control chart named X bar S. Yeah, so see, I have a control chart of a cheese bread weight, yes? And so I have, for example, first day. Let's suppose I have day one, day two, day three, day four, day five, yeah? Let's suppose I have here day. 10 days, yeah? And then on day one, the mean is here. Day two, the mean is here. Day three, the mean is here. Day four, the mean is here. Day five, the mean is here. From day three to day six, the mean is going up. Who, type here for me, from 0 to 10, how easy it is for you to see that from 0 to 10. When you look here, I have 10 days in a row, yeah? How easy it is for you to see this. Yeah, from 0 to 10. Wonderful, excellent. And then I have here the standard deviation of day 1. Ah, interesting. And then I have here the standard deviation of day 2. Ah, interesting. Very interesting. Very interesting. So, I have there my production of cheese bread, cheese bread, cheese bread, cheese bread. I go and I take randomly 10 cheese breads on Monday, for example, boom. Then I have 10 numbers. I have 10 numbers. 10 numbers are here from Monday. From Monday. I have these 10 numbers. Wonderful. Then I go ahead and I calculate mean. And I go ahead and I calculate standard deviation. Okay. And then I do the same thing for day 2, day 3, day 4. Okay, what's the advantage of plotting things over time? What's the advantage? Why should I plot, data points over time? Why? Well, because I can check if there is an outbreak, I can check if there is a trend, if there is a shift, a drift in the process, if there is sawtooth, I can check so many amazing things. By the way, time series plot, any sort of time series plot, control charts or classic time series plot, simply plot using Excel, for example, this is immensely valuable, immensely valuable. So please plot, yes. You can detect, in the case of a control chart, we call special causes. You can detect special causes. A special cause type 1 is an outbreak, one data point above upper control limit or one below lower control limit. But there are other types of special causes. For example, when you have a certain number of data points operating above mean, even if they are within the control limits, below mean, if we have 6 data points going up, 6 data points going down, 9 data points on the same side of the mean, or 14 data points going up and down. And there are many other rules for special causes. Yes? Rules for special causes. And then you may, how much are we on the same page from 0 to 10? How much are we on the same page from 0 to 10? From the things that I've talked about so far. And you may be thinking, Professor Marcelo made a mistake. Today's masterclass is about Cpk and Ppk capability analysis. Why is Marcelinho talking about stability? Why is Professor Marcelo talking about control charts? Why? Guys, because you cannot calculate CPK or PPK if you do not check stability first. You must check stability first. CPK was proposed by 2 Japanese engineers as an additional, as a post-analysis to be performed in conjunction or right after a control chart. Because see that control charts, we do not have specification limits. These are not specification limits. These are control limits. These are control limits. But is my client happy or unhappy? I don't know. then I need to include my specification limits. Yeah. Cpk, many people associate C to capability, P to potential, and K to katayori. Katayori. Katayori is a Japanese word. A Japanese word that means offset or bias or location. Yeah? I don't know if you guys know, but Japanese words normally have multiple meanings. Yes? Multiple meanings. But that's the point. You must check stability before running a capability analysis. Yeah? Very important. Yes, Jason. Yes. Wonderful. So now let me go ahead and calculate CPK, stat quality tools, capability analysis, normal. Ah, by the way, we should run a normality test here. Very important, very important. Our individual data should behave according to a normal probability distribution. Okay? Very important, very important. So stat, quality tools, capability analysis, normal. Subgroup size is 10. And then let's suppose we have here from 7 to 13. Yeah? From 7 to 13. These are specification limits. Yeah. And then our objective today is to fully understand, you know, CPK and PPK and see the difference. Yeah. Yeah. See the difference. So, okay. Wonderful. Wonderful. I want you to tell me if this probability distribution here seems to fit in this garage here. Imagine that this is a car and this is a garage. This is garage, this is a car. Do you think do you think this car is well parked? Yes or not? What do you think? Yeah, I think it's okay. It is okay. It is okay. We would be very much worried, or much more worried, if we had something like this, for example. If we had something like this. Garage, yeah, and then the car. Then we would be much, much, much more worried. Yeah? So from 7 to 13. Yeah? We are good. Yes, Catherine, for sure. Because as I've mentioned before, we would love to see these numbers here, at least in which value? You guys tell me. And guys, just give me 30 seconds. 30 seconds and I'll be back, okay? Hello, 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 I'm back. I'm back. Can you guys hear me? Bom dia, Antônio Carlos. Tudo bem? Okay. And then, let's take a look now. How can we interpret? How can we interpret CPK? Okay, how can we interpret CPK? How can we find this number here? Yeah, and I think I will open up here an Excel. Yeah, and CPK is equal to the minimum value between CPL and CPU. Who knows that? Type here yes if you know that. So see that we have here CPU and CPL. Yeah, Marcelo, what is CPU? CPU is not from computer, okay? CPU is equal to upper specification limits minus mean divided by 3 times standard deviation. And CPL is and the mean is sample mean, okay? CPL is mean minus lower spec limit divided by 3 times standard deviation, okay? Wow, interesting, very interesting, very interesting. Now, what if I tell you that PPK PPK is the minimum value between PPL and PPU, and that PPU and PPL have these formulas. Now we are in trouble. Because you are saying that CPL is upper spec limit minus mean divided by 3 times the standard deviation. And PPU is upper spec limit minus mean divided by 3 times the standard deviation. So, I mean, what's going on here? Who knows? Any green belt? Green belts? Black belts should know for sure. What's the trick here? What's the point here? Certified green belts should have at least some reaction here. So what is missing here in these standard deviations? For CPK, I am talking about within. Within. And for PPK, I am talking about overall. And that's why I have this dotted line here that is within. Yeah, the solid line, it is overall. That's why I have two probability distributions. I have two probability distributions. And that's why I have two different standard deviations. So, for PPK, this standard deviation here is overall. And for CPK, CPU and CPL, it is within. It is with you. So, if we want to understand the difference between CPK and PPK, we must understand the difference between these two standard deviations. Does it make sense? Type here yes if that makes sense for you. If we want to understand the difference between CPK and PPK, at this point we are talking about understanding the difference between standard deviation overall and standard deviation within. And I'm going to start by the easiest one. The easiest one is standard deviation overall. What is standard deviation overall? What is standard deviation overall? How is this 0.90, you know, calculated? Well, I will simply take all these 100 data points, all my data points, regardless subgrouping. I don't know the size of the subgroups, I don't care. I'll just take all these data points and calculate the sample standard deviation. Square root of summation of mean minus each data point squared divided by n minus 1. Simple. And the software will do this for us. But the most important thing to keep in mind is that this standard deviation here, for example, one of the ways to calculate this is going by going in descriptive statistics. If you take this standard deviation here, 0.90, it is exactly the same of this standard deviation, yes? With like six decimal places, see? It's exactly the same. But more than knowing how to calculate, the most important thing to keep in mind is I am closing my eyes to subgroups. I don't care if the performance on the variation on day 3 was different from the variation on day 1. For PPK, I don't care. And that's why we say that overall has to do with what customers are feeling. Does it make sense? Because investigators, we care about, wow, how was the variation on day 6, on day 8? On day 10. Yeah? From 0 to 10, how much are we on the same page? And then, what is the thing with this within standard deviation? What is within standard deviation? Within what? Within kind of a inside. Within what? Within what? Who knows? Internal, but internal to what? The variation per day. No, it's within subgroups. Yes, Kevin. And in this case, within each day. Within each day, within subgroups. But how many subgroups do I have here? How many subgroups? How many subgroups? Yes. 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 And then we have different standard deviations, right? We have different standard deviations per day, per subgroup. And the within standard deviation is just one number. Yes? Are you guys following me? I have different standard deviations here, but the within standard deviation here, it is just one number, 0.889. And see that it is not just the average of the standard deviations. It is not. See, this number here is different from this number here, from this number here, it is different. It is different. So the within standard deviation comes from a weighted average of variances. And it is weighted by the subgroup size. Yeah, are you guys familiar with this expression? Weighted average. And we weight by the subgroup size. Yeah? Of variances. And then we take the variance, and then we need to take the square root. The square root, okay? Okay, Marcelo, but what are the practical implications of CPK and PPK? Yeah? What are the practical implications? And by the way, just to guarantee that it is super clear, so let's take these numbers. Yeah, let's take these numbers. So, standard deviation overall, I will need standard deviation within, I will need mean, I will need upper spec limit, I'll need lower spec limit. Yeah, let's see if we can fully understand what's going on here. Yeah, so CPU standard deviation overall is 0.0974408. Standard deviation within is 0.889747. The mean is 10.0451. The upper spec limit is 13, lower spec limit is 7. Yes, I hope you are following me. And if you are not following me, let me know. Hi, Professor, when will you be doing the statistics? You guys tell me, with love. First of all, can you feel the love from my side, yes or not? Type here, yes or not. Can you feel that there is love from my side, yes or not? Yes or not? Do you think with love that it is adequate or inadequate to drop a logistics, an admin question in the middle of the most important part of a technical session. Do you think, with love, I'm okay. I'm just asking you. You guys are my clients, my friends, you know? I mean, I am at the middle of the most important part of the session. You know, it's a technical session. I am extremely concentrated, going little by little, thinking in terms of how to explain this in the easiest way possible. Extremely concentrated. We have few people here in the chat, so I'm looking for all the questions, and then all of a sudden, boom, drops, when is the next training for? You guys tell me, do you think this is adequate or inadequate? Come on, guys. Help me. With love, feel the love. You know, people asking if there is a certificate for this session that I am running here, and then people asking when is the next train. Come on, guys. This is a content that may change your life. Forget a little bit about documents, about PDF files. It's amazing that you have a lot of certificates and you put in your, you know, walls, and your family sees, and you apply for a job. That's amazing. But more important than that is what you have here inside. You know, certificates, these are external elements. I'm giving you a chance to understand something that is gold. Capability analysis is applicable everywhere. And not many people know this concept, truly know this concept very well. I am sharing fragments of my black belt course. I'm here for free for you guys, sharing elements of my black belt course, sometimes master black belt content. And then there are people asking me about, you know, about admin. We have our website, we have people in our team that can help, you know, answering that with love. Because when in the middle of an explanation like that, you drop a question like that, it suggests that you are not connected with me at all. You know, if in the middle of the, you know, this is like the final, this is the final chapter of your favorite, you know, book, you know, this is the magical moment. If at this point there is an admin question in the chat, I don't know what you are doing here. I don't know. If you go on, if you are looking for documents, for free certificates, there are many places you can find. Many places. If a free certificate for you is more important than this content, you can go to many places. You can search online for free certificates. Many places. You know, I am sharing gold with you, you know, and you are simply ignoring. You are ignoring gold. Okay? With love. Feel the love. I could be quiet, but I am your educator. And as your educator, as your mentor, on top of everything, I love you guys. I love you guys. I truly love you guys. And it's part of my responsibility to alert when there is something very dysfunctional. This is dysfunctional. This is hard to explain, you know? So once again, let me go back here little by little and let's understand now, yeah? Oh my God. Let's go there. Let's go there. CPU. Upper spec limit. Let's put a parenthesis here. Parenthesis. Upper spec limit minus mean. Boom. Divided by 3 times within standard deviation. Within standard deviation. Boom. CPL. And then we need to check if 1.10 or 1.11, if we round here to two decimal places, yeah, 1.11, CPU 1.11, yeah. Then we have mean minus lower spec limit divided by 3 times within standard deviation. Yeah? Yeah? And then let's do the same with PPU, upper spec limit minus mean divided by 3 times overall standard deviation. Yeah? Two decimal places. 1.09. Yeah? And here we have mean minus lower spec limit divided by 3 times overall standard deviation. Marcelo, but they are very, very, very similar. Marcelo, they are very, very similar. You know, these numbers are not very different. PPL from CPL, PPU from CPU, yeah? But now, maybe the most important moment of the session. Now, let me create one subgroup. Yeah, so let me create a crazy subgroup, yeah? And this crazy subgroup has a mean, very different mean. Take a look, 15. 15 is very different from 10. But the standard deviation is the same. The standard deviation is the same. Let me generate here 100 data points. It'll be a little bit different from the previous one. Yeah, so let me just refresh here the capability analysis with these results. It's a little bit different. And now let me add this crazy subgroup. For example, here, let's suppose on day two, we had this scenario here, okay? So you guys tell me, what has changed on day two? The mean or the variation or both? The mean or the standard deviation or both? What has changed? Perfect. The mean has changed. The mean, that's a let me rephrase my question. What has drastically changed? What has drastically changed? The mean or variation or both? What has drastically changed? So see that the mean has drastically changed. Yeah? And what I want to show you is, let's do this together. Let's do this together. PPK and CPK. So 1.11 and 1.10. Yes? When I update with these new data points, what happens? What has changed the most? CPK or PPK? So remember that both of them were around 1.1. Remember that. Who changed the most? PPK or CPK? PPK or CPK? And please, I want to see as many answers as possible, please. As many answers as possible. What has changed the most, CPK or PPK? So see, CPK is still around one. It has reduced, but it's still around one. But PPK has reduced in more than half. PPK has reduced in more than half. And see, here I can easily see the crazy subgroup. Why do you think CPK has not changed a lot? Why do you think CPK has not changed a lot? Because the mean has gone up, but with the same standard deviation. Because let's suppose we are in our manufacturing line of cheese breads. And then customers start complaining. Oh, there are cheese breads here that are way too big, way too big, way too big. And then you, as a belt, you go and investigate what's going on. When you find that in one single day, pretty much all cheese breads, all of them were not at 10 grams, but they were at the level of 15 grams, all of them, all of them. This is better news or not if you had some cheese breads with 20, some cheese breads with 10, some good, some with 15, some with 20, some with 10. You know, when you face a problem, it is better, it is less worse than, you know, having everything broken down, but equal. They are very similar. Or it's better to have scattered, you know, all over the place. Are you guys following me? Do you prefer to see, well, on that day, all cheese breads were big by this, all of them. So it was a disaster. But a disaster with low variation. It is better. It is better. Because why? Because very likely it is easier to fix. It is easier to fix. Yeah. Or it is easier at least to find the root cause. Let me rephrase that. I'm sorry. It is easier at least to find the root cause. And tell me scenarios where we can have this. Wow, Marcelo, only, you know, in one, only in one single day, in one single day, you know, we had like the problems, you know, concentrated there in one single day. Is it possible? Is it possible in real life? Oh, yes. A raw material batch, a machine that was broken and nobody saw. Yeah, we saw this at the end of the day. Maybe it's a new employee. It is possible. And if you have a scenario where it is very much concentrated, you know, it is easier. And then what is going on here is PPK is saying that our customer is very much unhappy. PPK is saying, wow, customers are very much unhappy. And CPK is saying, okay, customer is unhappy, but within, internally, you know, there is hope. There is hope. There is hope, you know. Differently, for example, if we had 10, 20, 11, 21, 10, 20, 11, 21, 10, 21, 11. Oops. Yeah, if we had a scenario like that, then take a look. Then we would have problem in the mean and problem in the standard deviation. Ah, and then in this case, take a look. In this case, we would have problems on PPK and also on CPK. On PPK and also on CPK. On PPK and also on CPK. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, tell me here, which index is more connected to what customer is feeling? Which index is more connected to what customer is feeling? I would not go there, Charles. Long term, short term, don't go there. Don't go there. Don't go there. I'm gonna show you guys something here. Yeah, and and CPK has to do with within variation. Within what? Within what? Within subgroups, beautiful, beautiful. Someone asked about about short-term and long-term. So let me share with you guys here. This is the second version of the Black Belt Handbook. Yes. And take a look here. This is on page... see the 173. So see, significant confusion abounds and contradictory statements pepper the literature with regards to meaning and determination of short-term and long-term capability and variation. ASQ, the American Society for Quality, maybe the most respected literature that we have. Yeah. And then there are different authors here. Briefogel suggests that capability indices and performance indices be considered long-term and short-term on the basis of the method used to calculate the estimation of sigma, yeah, the standard deviation of the population. Cp and Cpk represent long-term capability, while Pp and Ppk represent short-term capability. This is from the Automotive Industry Action Group. Wow. And they suggest Ppk for less than 30 days. Yes. And Cpk for everything thereafter. But then, I have a question for you. When I set as 30 days, I have a huge respect by the Automotive Industry Action Group. Gauge R&R, all the numbers that, all the reference that we use for Gauge R&R, for FMEA, you know, are from there. But when we set 30 days as a threshold for long-term and short-term, do you think this is dangerous or not? Because it depends on volume. Philips displays, we were producing 20,000 TVs per day. Per day. So maybe 1 week is enough for what they call long term. Maybe 1 week. Because in 1 week, we produced 140,000 TVs. 140,000 TVs. So again, as your mentor, as your educator, I strongly recommend that you don't go down this route, you know? Don't fall into this conversation of long-term, short-term. You go ahead and you calculate Cpk, Ppk, or sigma level overall, sigma level within, boom, measure phase. Analyze, you find root cause, implement solutions. On improved phase, then you measure again. Okay, this is sigma level before, this is sigma level after. No 1.5, no short term, no long term. That's it. And then, that's my opinion, is the worst alternative among these three, you know, found on literature. Yeah, and see that this is such a gray area that even ASQ positioned, you know, like black and white, you know, such a gray area. Because mainly this conversation about 1.5 sigma shift, you know, this is so popular and so wrong. And so wrong, yeah? Because see, this is absolutely impossible to back up. It is impossible to back it up with science, guys. It is impossible to back it up with science. Process will drift or shift plus or minus 1.5 sigma in the long term. This is impossible. How can you say that processes in general will drift or shift plus or minus 1.5 sigma long term? There is no solid scientific study that backs it up. Solid scientific study. And that's why when you find statisticians that don't like Six Sigma, the very first point of attack is the 1.5. Because in Lean Six Sigma, we do use a lot of statistics, but we are not statisticians. We are not mathematicians. We kind of borrow some tools and techniques from statistics to impact process, to improve our assertiveness. We don't have the objective to do all the calculations by hand to... Okay, but it doesn't mean that we can, you know, apply wrong concepts. And as your educator, as your mentor, yes, according to the my position in relation to that is black and white. You can disagree. If you disagree, I will respect that. But my position as your Lean Six Sigma educator, as your Lean Six Sigma mentor, professor, is stop using 1.5 and stop this conversation about long-term, short-term. Don't do that. Yes, Jason. Exactly. Short. Tears in heaven. Yeah, though. Every time that we add up 1.5, there is a shoe hurt, you know. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you've enjoyed this masterclass about the difference between Cpk and Ppk. Forget 1.5, forget long-term, short-term. The difference is pretty much associated to the way we estimate the standard deviation. K stands for Katayori, offset bias. Cpk use within standard deviation. What is within standard deviation? It's a standard deviation that is based on the weighted average of variances of the subgroup. Cpk considers subgroups. Okay, what's the practical implication of that? Wow, for investigation. Because if I have a problem, if I'm not meeting customer specs, I may, and my Cpk is good, I may find some isolated, concentrated problems. Yeah, this is very, very important. And what about PPK? PPK is what customer feels. Why? Because PPK does not consider subgroups. does not consider. We just take all the data points and boom. For both CPK and PPK, it's important to evaluate stability first, normality as well, in the way that we did here. Yes, wonderful. I hope you've enjoyed that. Thank you so much for joining me. I went a little bit above upper spec limit. Yeah, I told you guys from 30 to 60 minutes, but I always get so excited to talk about that, even more with the engagement that we have here in our chat. And once again, I hope this concept is internalized in your heart and you can make right decisions, you can impact businesses, you can impact your customers, and you can become an amazing, well-respected green, black, master black belt. Okay? Thank you so very much, guys. Thank you.